여러분도 아시겠지만 한반도는 20세기 전반부는 일본 제국주의에 의한 식민지 시대를 겪었고, 20세기 후반부는 현재까지 진행형인 남북 분단 시대를 겪고 있습니다.
Okay. As you well know about Korean Peninsula, the first half of the 20th century in Korea had the colonial period by Japanese Empire, and second half of 20th century in Korea is still ongoing process with the division of two Koreas, North Korea and South Korea.
그 한복판 1950년에 남북이 전쟁을 한 코리안 워가 깊은 상처로 남아 있습니다.
In the middle, in 1950, we had the terrible memory of the Korean people who had to go through the war, which is called Korean War.
그래서 1960년, 70년대는 군사정부 시절이어서 민주화가 많이 상처를 받은 그런 어려운 시대를 겪게 됐습니다.
For 1960s and
70s.
1960s to 1970s, Korean people had also go through some injury in terms of democratization because we had to go through the times occupied or dominated by the militarism.
1980년대에 광주라고 하는 남부 지방의 큰 도시에서 군사정부에 의한 대량 학살 사건이 광주 민주 항쟁 운동이라는 것이 일어났습니다.
And in 1980, there was massive massacre that took place in Gwangju, as it was the movement for the democratization held by the people in Gwangju, which is located in southern part of Korea.
그 무렵에 젊은 미술가 몇몇 중심으로 민주화 운동에 참여하는 그런 움직임이 시작됐고, 그중에 대표적인 그룹이 현실과 발월이라는 그룹이 1979년도에 창립됐습니다.
Around that time, the young artists were participating in the democratization movement. And we can say that one of the leading movements were held by the literary coterie by the name Reality and Utterance that was found in 1979.
매주 학습을 하고 그 결과를 작품으로 연결해서 그 작품을 모아서 첫 전시를 개최했는데, 정부에 의해서, 군사 정권에 의해서 그 전시가 무산되는 이제 사건이 벌어졌습니다.
So this reality and utterance literary coterie had a special program to study the arts every week, and they came up with some artistic works. And the works were collected, and they were trying to hold the first exhibition, but that exhibition was again stopped by the militarism.
민중 아트라는 말이 처음으로 이제 사용되게 됐는데, 그 말은 정부에서 탄압하기 위해서 만든 말이지, 그러니까 부정적으로 사용되기 시작한 민중 아트라는 말이 이제 본격화되기 시작했습니다.
And Minjung art was used for the first time around that time, but that Minjung art, the word terminology itself, was in fact created by the government as the negative image for the artistic movement to suppress them.
아, 그래서 민중 미술이 본격화되는데 민중 미술은 이제 사회 참여적이고 민주화 운동에 같이 참여하면서 다양한 미술 활동을 벌이는데 그 중에 하나가 공공 미술로서의 벽화를 주목하게 됩니다. 바로 이제 이렇게 됩니다.
And the Minjung art went into full scale around that time, and Minjung art had participated in the social movement as well as the democracy movement. And there were various activities of art, and one of the activities was called public art, which is mural, as you can see over here.
지금 보시다시피 아주 순진한 내용의 건물 외벽을 장식한 그림인데 정부는 이 그림 그린 작가들을 다 구속을 하면서 이제 본격적으로 탄압하기 시작했습니다.
As you can see, this mural represents very innocent or pure contents that is to just decorate the exterior wall of the building, but government had arrested all the artists who were involved over here, and they started to suppress the artists.
사실은 미술대학 대학생들이 그린 뮤럴인데 이 그림을 제작하기 위해서 비계목 설치를 하게 되는데 나무로 이게 사다리형을 말하는 거죠. 그 비계목을 최병수라고 하는 미대생 시골 친구가 그 비계목을 목수 출신이어서 비계목을 만들어주게 됐습니다.
Okay, here this mural was drawn by a student in the art school in the university, and there was one laborer who was the friend of Che. Who was the friend of the artist, and this laborer had installed the scaffolding log. It's like a ladder, wooden ladder, to support the artist to draw the mural painting over there. And this person's name was Che Byung-seo, and he used to be a carpenter.
최병수 작품은 뒤에 소개하겠는데 경찰이 이 미술 대학생들을 구속하고 다 이제 조사를 하게 됐는데 단 그림을 직접 그린 사람들은 미술 대학 학생이어서 문제가 없었는데 한 사람만 직업을 노동자라고 말했습니다. 그래서 경찰이 본격적으로 그 최병수라는 사람을 집중 조사를 하게 됩니다. 노동자라는 단어 때문에.
Of course, I'm going to introduce you the works of Che Byung-seo later on. And anyway, because of this movement held by the Korean art students studying in the university, all the students were arrested for investigation. And except for one person, all the university students who studied arts were okay, and they had no problem to be released. But when it comes to this carpenter who built the scaffolding log for the artist to draw, his occupation was a laborer. And because of his profession, which was laborer, government took it as an issue to investigate thoroughly for this guy.
결국은 이 목수 출신인 최병수는 경찰이 만들어준 화가라는 직업으로 바뀌어서 석방이 됩니다. 그래서 관제 화가, 정부에서 강제적으로 만든 화가가 됐고 나와서 실질적으로 그림을 그리기 시작해서 진짜 화가가 됐습니다.
Okay. This person, Che Byung-seo, used to be a carpenter, but the government authority didn't want to take him as the carpenter or laborer to announce his status. Therefore, they said Choi Byung-soo was one of the artists, and he was forced to become an artist. And as he was released later, he actually studied art to become an artist.
예, 가버먼트 페인터가 된 거지. 이 그림은 경찰에 의해서 지워졌고 그 지운 법적 근거는 광고물 단속법에 의했습니다.
This mural was erased by the police, and they gave the reason why they erased this mural was because they it was the violation of the Enforcement Act of Advertisement.
아, 그래서 이 벽화 운동이 본격화되고 또 우리 전통 불화 중에 불화를 현대적으로 계승한 걸개 그림이라는 이런 뮤럴 무빙 뮤럴 일종의 그런 걸개 그림이 또 유행하기 시작했습니다. 이제 이런 식으로 전통을 새롭게 사회 풍자적으로 현실을 담은 걸개 그림 무빙 뮤럴이 유행하게 됩니다.
And I can say that the mural movement was entering into the full scale, and also you know there was some activities going on with the hanging paintings, and hanging paintings were based on the Buddhist paintings. In the past, in Korean history, there were a lot of Buddhist paintings, and at that time, the artist had succeeded the old traditional Buddhist paintings into contemporary art, and that is called moving mural. And this moving mural, which was the hanging painting, was renewed from the traditional way to satirize the situation in Korea.
이 걸개 그림의 내용들은 현실에서 따왔고 물론 그 현실을 비판하거나 풍자하거나 상징화하거나 이런 식으로 기존의 아카데미즘하고 다른 사회적 기능을 이제 도모하기 시작했죠.
And this hanging painting was promoting the activities in the society with the contents of the reality, and they had focused on criticism of the reality, satirization, or symbolic paintings of the reality. And it was against the existing academism.
자, 이 그림, 이 대형 그림은 바로 아까 목수 출신 최병수가 연세대학이라는 대학에서 학생들과 함께 그린 그림입니다. 이 건물에 설치했기 때문에 그 사이즈를 짐작할 수 있을 것 같습니다.
This is the huge mega painting work drawn by the artist who used to be a carpenter. His name is Choi Byung-soo, and this painting was drawn together with the students in Yonsei University. And in fact, this is the mural painting drawn on the wall of Yonsei University. And you can imagine how big this picture is.
그림 내용은 시위에 참가하던 연세대 대학생이 경찰이 쏜 총에 맞아 사망하는 그런 사건이 있었습니다. 그 한여리를 살려내라라고 하는 그 내용을 시위 현장에서 많이 쓰게 되는 그런 대표적 이미지가 됐습니다.
The details of this painting had something to do with the demonstration. There was one student of Yonsei University killed by the police gun, and there was the demonstration on the street performed by the university students, and the slogan was to bring the life of Hanyeol back. And this is one of the leading painting to show that there was this demonstrative hanging mural.
이제 이렇게 해서 대형 걸개 그림들이 대학가를 장식하게 됐고, 또 대형 집회 시위 현장에 등장하기 시작했습니다.
So this mega size of hanging paintings were decorated by in the university, and also this hanging paintings were used for the demonstration or you know mega assemblies on the street.
이때 현상 중에 하나는 미술대학 졸업생들이 공장에 취업해서 실제 공원 생활을 하게 되는 노동 현장으로 가는 특이한 현상도 나타나기 시작했습니다.
One interesting phenomenon was that university students who studied arts in the university, graduate from university, thereafter they went to work in the factory as a normal laborer. It's like a fake employment to work together with the laborers.
노동 운동이 또 본격화되는데 이 그림 역시 노동 해방, 노동자 권익을 주장하기 위한 그런 주제의 그림이 되겠습니다.
This was the beginning of labor movement, which asserts the liberation of labor and the rights of laborers.
시위에 희생당한 학생의 장례 행렬을 거대하게 했는데 그때도 역시 이제 미술이 큰 역할을 하게 됩니다.
This is a kind of funeral procession for one student who was sacrificed by in the process of demonstration.
자, 이렇게 이제 대형 집회 현장의 걸개 그림이라 새로운 장르가 인기를 끌면서 집회 현장에 빠지지 않는 주요 작품으로 등장하게 됐습니다.
Okay, this became the main or major features in the mega assembly where many people are gathered together, and this hanging painting became very popular for any events, especially with a lot of people in the mega assembly.
전국 대학가에 미술 그룹이 생겨서 벽화나 이런 걸개를 본격적으로 그림을 그리기 시작했는데 그 학생들은 미대생이 아닌 다른 전공의 일반 대학생들이 이제 그림 그룹에 참여해서 전국화 됩니다.
Okay. A lot of university students who are not really from the art school joined the art group to draw some pictures like hanging paintings and murals focused in the university. And as mentioned, that they are not art school students, and they are just normal students. But this activity took place across the country.
80년대 한국에서 미술 운동의 큰 특징을 말씀드린다면, 아티스트와 일반 학생을 비롯한 일반인과 결합해서 새로운 미술 운동을 시작했다는 그런 특징을 들 수 있습니다.
Okay. If I may give you the special characteristics of the art movement in 1980s in Korea, it was like a new mega art movement combined by artists who studied arts as well as those general people who did not study arts.
기왕의 미술 운동은 미술가 미술 각길이 미술계 내부에서 하는 운동이었다면, 민중미술 운동은 일반 시민과 작가와 예술가와 같이 공동체를 이루면서 새로운 민주화 운동에 참여했다는 그런 특징이 있다는 뜻입니다.
In the past, the art movement was performed together with the artists internally. But this new movement, new art movement that took place in 1980s, were another addition that includes the citizens, artists, and the general community. To work for this movement for democracy.
전국 대학 캠퍼스 안에 이런 식으로 큰 대형 빌딩에 학생들이 스스로 자진해서 이런 벽화를 그리기 시작했습니다. 미술이 사회적 기능을 크게 역할하게 되는 그런 특징을 보였습니다.
The art had shown a very special function in the society by this kind of activities. As you can see from this painting, in the campuses in the campuses across the country, university students volunteered themselves to draw a mural on this kind of big mega building.
지금 보시는 내용들이 그렇고 이 주제는 여대생이 통일운동에 참여해서 노스코리아 평양을 방문하고 온 사건이 있었는데 그 여학생을 통일운동의 상징으로 이렇게 벽화로 그렸습니다.
This mural's theme is the symbol of unification movement. In fact, there was one female university student who was very active in participating for the unification movement. And this female student went to visit North Korea. So this symbolized the this female student's visit to North Korea to represent the unification movement.
자, 이런 식으로 집회 한국 근대 역사를 주제로 한 대형 작품인데 결국은 정부에 의해서 다 파괴된 그런 사례가 또 생겼습니다.
It shows a kind of assembly or rally, and the theme for this painting was to talk about the Korean modern history, but this painting was destroyed by the government.
전시는 각 대학가에도 그림 전시를 했지만 공장을 비롯한 어느 곳이든지 그러니까 살롱 취향의 이런 호화스러운 미술관이나 화랑 같은 전시장이 아닌 길거리나 공장이나 이런 장소를 가리지 않고 전국 어디서나 이런 그림 전시가 이루어지면서 그림의 기능을 새롭게 보게 했습니다.
This picture shows the new function of art that can be shown anywhere in Korea. Regardless of the places, be it the street or factories, because some paintings were also exhibited in the university area, and in the past it used to be only exhibited somewhere in the gallery or exhibition, which can represent the richness or luxury. To show the taste of salon, but this became a new trend to exhibit the artworks anywhere.
화가들이 이렇게 일반 시민과 참여해서 미술 운동을 펼쳤다는 큰 특징이 있으면서 또 한편으로는 본인 고유의 창작 활동도 활발히 하게 됐습니다.
I would like to say that the artist was very artists were very active in participating in the art movement together with the normal general citizens, 민중. And in the meantime, they also focus on the creation of their own unique works.
우리 한국 역사를 권력 중심에서 해석한 그런 관제성 역사 기술을 이제 민중 중심으로 역사를 다시 보기 시작했고 그런 결과로 이런 작품을 이제 그리게 됩니다.
So this kind of works were created by the artists at the time as they had reinterpreted the history of Korean history. In the past, Korean history was interpreted more focused on the power, but they reinterpreted it into the history of democracy.
서양 미술을 받아들이는 데 있어서도 주체적 시각이 중요하다 하는 우리의 자주성을 새롭게 중심에 두게 됐고 그런 결과로 서양 미술에 대한 재조명이 돼서 이와 같이 풍자 그림도 나오게 됩니다.
So, of course, Korea had received some influence from the Western arts. However, Korean arts trend also had showed that we need to be autonomous or we needed to be independent in creating the work in Korea. And we can say that the Western art shed a new light on the autonomous arts Korean artists wanted to create, and this became a new trend to satirize the scene over there.
이 그림은 뭐잘 알려져 있다시피 몽드리안 그림을 기본으로 해서 다양한 현실 풍자를 주제로 한 작품입니다만 이 그림의 작가는 아주 가난한 집안 출신으로 사회 밑바닥에 여러 직업을 전전하면서 살다가 나중에 민중미술운동에 참여해서 본격적으로 화가가 된 그런 경우에 화가입니다.
Okay, the artist who created this work had the theme called Satirization of the Reality. He so as you can see, it is the Mondrian Hotel. It is based on the Mondrian Hotel to satirize the reality. This particular artist came from a very poor family. And he had to work all sorts of dirty works, maybe 3D works at the time in the society. But later on, he emerged as an artist after he studied arts.
그래서 당시 화가들이 주목한 주제들은 도시와 농촌의 문제, 또 부자와 가난한 빈부 차이의 문제, 이런 사회의 여러 가지 문제점들을 자신의 작품의 주제로서 담기 시작했습니다.
At the time, the artists had the theme in their work, focusing on the difference between, I mean, the problems or the difference between the life in the urban area or rural area, or some problems arising from the difference between the rich and the poor. So they were focusing on the theme of the society.
농촌이 도시화되는 그런 산업화의 문제점을 주제로 담은 이 그림은 마치 논을 아파트 단지를 만들기 위해서 이런 공사를 한 그런 풍경을 사실적으로 그렸습니다.
This painting is a realistic painting that shows that the rice field was used to build the flats, group of flats, and the rural agricultural land became urbanized. And this picture addressed the issue of industrialization.
당 80년대에 공안미학이란 새로운 단어가 나왔는데, 검찰이 화가를 구속하고 탄압하면서 정부 사이드에 새로운 미학, 미술을 해석하는 그런 독특한 용어가 나오기 시작했습니다.
In the beginning of 1980s, at that time, there was the aestheticism, which was a new word for the authority. Police had arrested the people or the artists and suppressed them, and they tried to self praise themselves with the aestheticism.
이 작가가 역시 정부에 의해서 탄압을 받고 이 작품도 빼앗기게 되는데, 정부 차원에서, 그러니까 군사정부는 이 그림을 어떻게 해석했냐면, 지금 붉은 땅이 한반도의 모양이고, 한반도 전체가 붉은색으로 적화통일됐다. 그러니까 공산주의화됐다 해서 북한을 찬양한 그림이다. 이렇게 해석을 했습니다.
This is another painting that government was involved to suppress the artist, and the work itself was seized by the government. The interpretation of the military regime was that the red color is the land in Korea, Korean Peninsula, and Korean Peninsula became red altogether. So red means communism, and they say that Korea became Korea was occupied by that communism, and this is to have that propaganda of North Korea.
그런 내용이 80년대 민중미술의 단면을 보여줬다 봅니다.
So in 1980s, such activities were performed by the government.
같은 이목상 작가가 Ordinary People 주제로 해서 의미 부여한 그런 종이 부조 작품이 되겠습니다.
This is the theme called Ordinary People, created by the same writer, same painter. Called Im Ok-sang. It is the material was a paper, so they used this ink, black ink.
역시 같은 작가가 목사님을 그렸는데, 이 무니칸 목사는 통일운동에 앞장섰던 목사이신데, 평양을 노스코리아를 다녀온, 그래서 감옥으로 간 그런 사건의 주인공입니다.
Im Ok-sang, the same painter, had drawn this image of Pastor Moon Ik-kwan. Moon Ik-kwan is a very famous figure who was leading the unification movement in South Korea, and he had visited North Korea, Pyongyang. Because of that, when he came back to Korea, he was prisoned.
같은 작가의 한국 전쟁의 가족 기념 사진입니다. 전쟁 전과 전쟁 후를 비교했는데, 전쟁 이후에 찍은 가족 사진에는 빈칸이 있죠. 전쟁에서 죽었다는 뜻입니다.
You can see two different drawings on the same page. This was created by the same same artist, Im Ok-sang, and this actually is the family group photo taken before Korean War and after Korean War. But the difference between these two paintings, as you can see on the right, after the Korean War, there are some empty spaces because they passed away during Korean War.
남북 분단의 비무장지대 DMZ가 있습니다. 그 DMZ 부근에 미군 군사지대가 있는데 그 미군들 주둔지에서 수집한 사진을 이렇게 콜라주한 겁니다.
Okay, in Korea, as you know, Korea is divided by two Koreas, and in between, we have this demilitarized zone called DMZ. And near in the DMZ area, there is military base town, military base for American armed forces. And in the American armed forces base town, this picture shows. The pictures were collected from that American base town or American stationed base, and it was the collage.
예, 젊은 여성 화가가 당시에 암울한 사회를 상징화한 작품이 되겠습니다.
This is the work that symbolized the very dark society at that time. It was created by one young female artist.
민중미술은 마이너 장르를 주목한 그런 특징도 있는데 목판화라든가 출판 미술이라든가 카춘 만화라든가 이런 장르를 새로 주목해서 많은 작가를 또 배출하게 됩니다.
Minjung art also had to taken note of the minor genre, such as prints, photos, cartoons, murals, and so on. As the Minjung art had focused on the new genre, there have been many new artists cultivated from different genres.
80년대 대표 작가 중에 하나인 오윤이라는 목판화 화가가 있었는데 일찍 요절 죽는 바람에 더 좀 안타깝게 했지만 그 작가가 대표 작가로 지금 추모하고 있습니다. 네.
Okay. One of the leading artists in 1980s is Oh Yun. This artist was focusing on the wooden print, and unfortunately, he passed away at a very young age. And he represents the signature artist for paint for prints.
지금 보시는 이 그림은 유화 작품입니다만 전통 불교 회화 중에 지옥을 그린 지옥도를 차용해서 자본주의 사회를 풍자한 그림입니다.
This oil painting satirizes the capitalism, borrowing the traditional Buddhist painting representing the hell.
이 지옥 지옥인데도 불구하고 거기에 코카콜라, 맥심 커피, CX 오일 이런 선전 광고 간판이 있습니다. 상업주의는 지옥에까지 가서 이렇게 비즈니스를 한다는 그런 풍자를 담았습니다.
This is a kind of a satirical artwork. Although it is hair, as you can see from the picture, there are some advertisement billboards such as Maxim Coffee, Coca-Cola, CX Oil that represent the commercialism. Even in the hell, they still focus on commercialism.
화가는 자기 동료 비평 미술 비평가를 역시 지옥으로 보냈는데 왼쪽 위에 네 명의 남자가 앉아 있습니다. 이제 벌 받기 위해서 기다리는 중인데 오른쪽 끝은 화가 본인의 모습이고 옆에 있는 세 명은 미술 평론가입니다.
Okay, can you pay attention to the top left. Portion on the left? There are four men sitting and waiting for punishment, I think. And this painter, this artist Oyun, had sent the other three critics who criticized the paintings of the artist at that time. So one on the right is the painter himself, Mr. Oyun, but the other three guys are all the Korean critics at that time. And yeah, they are waiting for the punishment.
왼쪽 끝에 있는 얼굴이 가장 벌을 크게 져서 칼을 쓰고 지옥에서도 중재인한테 무거운 죄를 지은 중재인한테 씌우는 칼인데 그런 칼을 쓰고 있는 사람이 바로 여러분이 보시는 저 본인 윤범무입니다.
By the way, okay, the right, yeah, the person on the right end. With the, I think fixed rectangular type of knife on the body, with the head outside, as you can see, he represents myself. That person is myself, drawn by this artist Oyun. And because I sinned, or I committed, you know, heavy sins. That is why I am punished in a heavy way compared to other people.
세월이 많이 가서 제가 제 모습 죄송합니다. 많이 늙어 있죠. 저 그림 속의 젊은 얼굴이.
In fact, that is my face. But as time went by, I'm so sorry. My face is changed. But that used to be the picture of my younger days.
저는 확신합니다. 젊은 시절에 대표적인 화가 오윤이 저를 지옥으로 보냈기 때문에 진짜 죽어서는 지옥에 가지 않을 것으로 확신합니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am very confident and sure that I will not go to the hell when I die and when I leave this world because I already was sent to the hell by this painter, Mr. Oyun, I'm sure.
우윤 작가의 대표적인 목판화가 되겠습니다.
So this is the signature wooden print of Mr. Oyun.
세계 문학전집을 발간 기념으로 제가 포스터를 제작하게 됐는데 우윤 작가한테 돈을 만들어 주기 위해서 부탁했더니 이 목판화를 만들어 왔습니다.
Okay. I was trying to produce coasters to commemorate the print publication of the World Literature Collection, and I asked Oyun, Mr. Oyun, this artist, to give me one work, and he had given this work to me.
외세 서양에서 불어오는 강한 바람을 맞고자 자기 아들을 감싸고 있는 아버지의 모습입니다.
Okay, this figure shows that a father is trying to cover his own son by protecting him with because there is a very strong wind coming from the west.
출판사 사장이 세계 문학 전집을 선전하기 위한 포스터인데 오히려 서양으로부터 불어온 바람을 거역을 하면 어떻게 책을 팔라냐고 저를 질타하게 한 야단치게 한 그런 작품입니다.
Okay, I'm sorry. Earlier on, I think I said that it was a poster, but it's a poster. This is the poster for commemorating publication of that world, the collection for world literature. And I asked him to give me one special prints of his work. And he gave me this work. So I was scolding him. How come you are, you know, giving me this painting? Because this painting shows that, you know, the father is covering his son to try to protect his son from the wind, very strong wind coming from the west. As I am publicizing the book, the world literature book.
이제 오윤은 전통을 새롭게 해석해서 많은 수의 목판화를 남기게 되는데 오윤 자신 집안이 아버지는 유명한 소설가였고 또 어머니 쪽에 전통 무용을 실제 실현하는 문화재 인간 문화재 집안입니다. 그래서 전통 춤에 대한 이해도가 상당히 깊었고 오유는 무당이 돼야 예술가는 무당이 돼야 된다라고 주장한 바 있습니다.
This artist had said that artist has to be you know how do you call you know totemism you know someone who is performing as
a shaman.
So the artist has to be the medium of shaman. Oyun had interpreted newly about the tradition, and he created this wooden print. His father was a very famous
novelist,
and his mother used to be a traditional dancer. And his mother was appointed as the live intangible property in Korea. As such, he had a very deep understanding of the traditional dance in Korea.
역시 오윤 작품, 예, 우리 전통 연희를 예, 새롭게 해석한 작품.
This is another work of Mr. Oyun, the artist. He had a new interpretation of this traditional agricultural farming dance.
남북 통일을 기원했지만 대동세상 공동체 사회를 주제로 한 그런 내용이 되겠습니다.
This picture is wishing the unification of North and South Korea, but also at the same time, the theme of this painting is to create the community, one community of Korean world.
조각가도 다수 이 80년대 운동에 참여했고요.
Sculptors also participate in the 80s Minjung art movement a lot.
구도자인데 몸에 상처를 입고 있네요.
So this person is a religious person, but he has a lot of injuries on the body.
그 시대가 시대를 상징하는 이미지입니다.
This symbolizes the era at the time.
남쪽에 제주도라는 섬이 있는데 거기에 양민 학살, 일반 시민을 학살한 대형 4.3 사건이 있었는데 그 사건의 현장을 주제로 그린 작품입니다.
This artwork has the theme of major massacre that took place in Jeju Island. Jeju Island is located in the southern tip of Korea as one separated island, and there a lot of citizens were massacred by the authority.
농촌에 있는 농부들이 도시의 환상을 갖고 고향을 떠나는 젊은 여자의 모습을 바라보고 있는 작품입니다.
Okay. This painting shows that people are looking at the young female protagonist living the agricultural farm with the fantasy of good life in urban area.
같은 작가의 모내기라고 하는 시골의 농사 장면을 그린 그림인데 이게 80년대의 사건의 대표적인 작품이 돼서 검찰에 압수돼서 지금까지 작가한테 반납되지 않은 그림입니다.
This painting was drawn by Shin Hak-chul, same as the earlier painting I showed you in the slide. It is the rice planting in Korea, you know, where the farmers have to plant the new rice plants. But this was the representative work in 1980s. And it was seized by the prosecutor's office in Korea, and it was not returned back to the painter yet.
이 그림을 그린 신학철 화가는 이 그림 때문에 이 그림도 압수됐지만 실질적으로 오랜 동안 감옥 생활을 하게 됩니다. 왜 그러냐면 이 그림을 공안미학 아까 정부 차원의 검찰이 해석하는 그 해석 방법이 독특했기 때문에 그렇습니다. 어떻게 해석했을까요?
Okay, I'm going to explain about this picture, but at the same time, I want you to have a guess. As mentioned, that this picture was seized by the prosecutor's office in Korea, and Shin Hak-chul, who was the artist, were imprisoned for many years. And as mentioned earlier, the Korean government had the aestheticism of the government. And government interpreted in different way. That's why they had seized him. I mean, they had seized this work. And also at the same time, they arrested him to be in prison for many years. How do you think the government had interpreted this picture?
아래쪽은 남한을 상징하는데 온갖 쓰레기로 꽉 차 있고 특히 미국이 보낸 군사 물자를 포함한 여러 가지 각종 쓰레기가 있는 반면 북쪽은 북한을 상징하는데 거기는 파라다이스로 그렸다는 이유였습니다.
Okay. Their interpretation was that the sin on the bottom represents South Korea, and South Korea is filled with a lot of waste, and the waste include, of course, waste maybe generated by the people in Korea, but at the same time, the waste came from the relief work given by the American armed forces, because at that time they gave a lot of resources to South Korea at that time, and they represent this waste in South Korea. At the same time, if you can see the picture on above, this picture represents North Korea, but North Korea is like a paradise, so it is against the truth they interpreted.
80년대 한국의 경찰은 이렇게 독특하게 미술 보는 안목을 가졌던 아주 좋은 시대였습니다.
So I can say that 1980s can be interpreted as a very good times as the Korean authority or the police had interpreted the arts in such a manner.
같은 작가의 이제 다양한 그림 몇 점을 보겠습니다.
And I would like to show you various works of Shin Hak-chul, the same artist.
한국 근대 역사를 초현실적으로 이렇게 콜라주했습니다.
So this is a work of collage which shows the surrealism of history of modern Korea.
또 80년대 중요 작가 중에 하나가 황재형이라는 작가가 있는데요. 이 작가는 미술대학을 졸업하고 광산으로 가서 실제 마이너 광부 생활을 3년간 하게 됩니다.
Okay. This is another new artist work by the name of Hwang Jae-hyung. He's a very important artist in 1980s. He studied arts in the university. After he finished his education in the university, he went to work in the mining industry as a mining worker for 3 years.
그래서 광부 생활을 하면서 광산촌의 다양한 인물과 풍경을 본격적으로 그리기 시작했어요.
As he was working as a mining worker in the mining town, he had the targets like people and scenery in the mining town.
갱 속에서 석탄을 캐는 광부들이 그 갱 안에서 식사하는 모습입니다. 헤드랜턴은 각각 상대방을 비춰줘야 밝게 식사를 할 수 있는 광부 생활의 체험을 그림으로 그린 겁니다.
Okay, this artist went to the mining work in deep inside the mining town. That is why he knows when people have to eat deep inside the mining area. You know, they are having meals at the moment, but you know, they cannot see what it is in front, and your colleague have to use their headlight to shed light on the meal. That's when your colleague can eat the food.
저게 하얀 쌀밥인데 불 안에 석탄 가루가 꽉꽉 차 있어서 까만 밥으로 식사를 그런 체험을 담은 겁니다.
And they are digging coals, so it's a coal mining area. And because of the, you know, black powdery substances of coal scattered around, and as they are having their meal, the meal is composed of some rices, but the color of rice is black.
나중에는 에너지 정책이 바뀌어서 광산은 다 폐광, 문을 닫게 되고 그 광산촌은 폐허가 됩니다. 그래도 이 화가는 그 지역에서 살면서 지금까지 광산촌을 그리고 있습니다.
Due to the change of energy policy made by the government, this mining area had to be closed, and the mining area now is deserted. But this particular artist, Hwang Jae-hyung, still remained in the site and worked with this mining industry.
광산촌.
So this is another landscape of the mining town.
자, 리얼리즘의 극치이죠. 광산촌의 전용로를 이렇게 사실적으로 그렸습니다.
This is the extreme beauty of the realism. So the scenery of the mining village has been expressed in this manner.
이종구란 작가는 농촌 풍경을 사실적으로 그린 화가입니다.
Lee Jong-gu, who is the artist of this work, had painted in the realistic way of 농촌을요?
농촌.
The agricultural farming.
캠퍼스는 실제 쌀을 담은 푸대차루를 사용했고 실제 저 위에 뜯겨진 포스터들은 대통령 선거 포스터이네요.
Here in this work, you can see some torn posters, which composed of the election campaign of the candidates of the candidates of presidential candidates, and this particular canvas is made from the sack, the rice cake, the rice sack.
아까 말한 목수 출신 화가가 제작한 작품입니다.
This is another print work created by the artist who used to be a carpenter.
남북 분단을 극복하고 띄어놓고 이제 통일을 주제로 한 목판화입니다.
This painting is themed of the unification after overcoming the division of South and North Korea.
자, 두 사람이 끌어안고 통일을 주제로 한 역시 판화입니다.
This is another print with the theme of unification. Two persons are hugging each other here.
역시 같은 김중권 작가의 혁명을 혁명가의 초상을 이런 식으로 표현한 작품입니다.
This was created by Mr. Kim Jung-kwon, the same artist as earlier, and the theme is the portrait of the person who revolutionized.
일반 서민을 그린 젊은 작가의 그림입니다.
Another young artist who drew the ordinary people in Korea.
역시 노동자 집회를 사실적으로 그린 젊은 작가의 그림입니다.
Another work of young artist showing realism. This painting's theme is the rally made by the laborers. So it's a laborers' assembly.
사진 작품인데 아까 연세대학에서 시위에 참여했다가 죽은 경찰청에 맞서서 죽은 이한열 그 장면을 풍자한. 사진 작품이 되겠습니다.
This is the photographic work that satirizes the death of Lee Han-yeol, who was shot by the police during the demonstration. He studied in Yonsei University, Lee Han-yeol.
쿠데타에 성공한 군사 정권의 유명한 기념 사진이 있는데 그 사진을 풍자한 작품이 되겠습니다.
There is a very famous photography taken to represent the successful military coup, and this work satirizes that particular picture.
사실적으로 그린 작품이죠. 광주 항쟁을 주제로 한 겁니다.
This is the the resistance done by the Gwangju resistance. And that is the theme for this picture.
그래서 예, 몇몇 작품을 소개했는데 결론적으로 말씀드리면 80년대 한국에서의 민중 미술 운동은 미술가와 일반 시민과 결합한 민주화 운동으로서의 미술의 역할을 새롭게 보게 한 특징이 있습니다.
I'd like to conclude over here as I have introduced some works of 1980s. In conclusion, I can say that the artist and the public, the 민중, were together working to democratize the country and the 민중 art in 1980s had contributed to the democracy in Korea in 1980s.
당시 참여한 젊은 작가들은 미술로서 이른바 출세를 염두에 두지 않고 그러니까 이 작품을 뭐 비싸게 팔거나 어디 공모전에 내서 상을 타거나 뭐 이런 식으로 화가로서의 출세를 지향한 게 아니라 꿈꾼 것이 아니라 미술 자체를 사회에서의 어떤 선작용, 좋은 역할을 하게 하는 방식으로서 미술을 선택했다고 봅니다.
So a lot of young artists at the time who participate in Minjung art, they do not really think of their own success in art industry. They could sell their works at very expensive price, or they could participate in some public prized participation work, but they did not really participate in such work to receive prizes from any organization, and they did not really try to seek success in their career. Rather, they really contributed their work in art industry or art world to do a good work for the people, for 민중.
군사 정부 시절이었기 때문에 정통성을 갖지 않는 이 정권이 예술 탄압을 아주 심하게 했습니다. 그래서 탄압이 민중 미술을 낙해한 모태, 어머니 역할이라고 역설적으로도 말할 수 있습니다.
During this military regime, they were not justified as the you know, the normal government by the citizens or the people. That is why at the time, the military regime had suppressed arts a lot. And because of their suppression, 민중 art was born.
당시 참여한 주요 작가들은 좀 순진했다, 순수했다 라고 볼 수 있는데 바로 저의 경우만 해도 그렇습니다. 저는 삼성그룹에서 당시 월급을 무지무지 많이 받는 그런 평범한 시민이었는데 이 민중미술을 지원해서 저 자신도 상당히 많은 제재를 손해를 본 바 있습니다.
Okay. So I can say that most of the major artists who participate in 민중 art were really innocent or pure. And if I may explain about myself, I used to work for Samsung Group in the past, which allowed me to collect quite a big sum of the salary every month, and I could enjoy my life. But instead, I participate in the citizens' movement, and yeah, of course, I incurred the damage, but here I am.
look in my face. 감사합니다. 예.
Thank you very much.